Good evening, everybody. I'd like to call the City Caucus meeting to order for Monday, September 24th, 2018. And we have one public hearing on the agenda this evening, if I can ask the clerk to read.
Public hearing number one, 2017 Consolidated Annual Performance and Evaluation Report, paper.
Thank you. And under consideration, we have 12 items. If the clerk can read item number one.
Item number one, under final consideration, an ordinance to amend Chapter 92 of the Code of the City of Schenectady regarding the creation of the Public Safety Foundation.
And that was discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number two.
Item number two, under original consideration, an ordinance accepting the proposed 2019 operating and capital budget, introduced only with a resolution calling for a public hearing.
And again, the public hearing is going to be on Tuesday, October 9th, because we have Columbus Day on October 8th. So again, that will be our regularly scheduled meeting, and the public hearing will be on Tuesday, October 9th at 7 p.m. And that was discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number three.
Item number three, a resolution establishing a standard workday and monthly credit for the New York State Retirement System for elected and appointed officials.
Also discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number four.
Item number four, a resolution setting fees for towing.
Discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number five.
Item number five, a resolution authorizing acceptance of an explosive detection canine team grant from the New York State Office of Homeland Security.
Discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number seven.
Item number six.
So let's go here. All right. So we're in item number six.
That's incorrect. Item number six, a resolution adopting the City of Schenectady Sexual Harassment Prevention Policy.
Thank you. And that was discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number seven.
Item number seven, a resolution authorizing the sale of 18 Close Street.
Discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number eight.
Item number eight, a resolution authorizing the sale of 1005 Davis Terrace.
Also discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number nine.
Item number nine, a resolution endorsing Better Neighborhoods, Inc. applications with Home Leasing LLC to New York State Homes and Community Renewal for State Housing Tax Credits and Community Investment Funds.
Also discussed in committee without objection and consent. Item number 10.
Item number 10, a resolution recognizing Hispanic Heritage Month.
And this will be presented at a future event by Mr. Councilman Montevideo. So again, discussed in committee without objection and consent. And item number 11.
Item number 11, a resolution recognizing the 10th anniversary of Coco House.
And this will be taken on board and presented by Councilwoman Cordozo. If there is nothing more to come before the City Council Caucus, I'd ask for a motion to adjourn. Motion by Ms. Palmieri, second by Mr. Montevideo. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned. And I'd like to call to order the City Council meeting for Monday, September 24th. And when we arrive, if I can just ask our folks to offer a moment of silence and remembrance for our Tuskegee Airmen and World War II Staff Sergeant Ralph Boyd Sr., who passed away over the weekend at the age of 99 years young and married for 68 years. So rest in peace, Mr. Boyd. I'm just a wonderful individual. So a moment of silence, and then we'll call for the invocation by Reverend Bill Levering and the pledge by Ms. Boyd.
Sacrifice of freedom. We pray for those who have given their lives in the path for our freedoms and privileges. God of legislation and supplication, be with our laws and our prayers. Help me to understand what people need from you, and help our lawmakers humbly seek to know and serve the needs of all people. As I wonder what people might be praying in their hearts, help these lawmakers imagine the human conditions in this city that need their touch. Help them to be creative and energetic, and not discouraged by short-sighted criticism and narrow naysaying. Help us all to serve the common good in uncommon ways, always with your help. In your holy name we pray.
Thank you.
you. And if I can ask the clerk to complete the roll call of the council, please. Mr. Palomino.
Here.
Ms. Porterfield.
Here.
Ms. Galuski-Wilzunis.
Here.
Ms. Peraza.
Present.
Mr. Rady.
Here.
Mr. Mutavera.
Present.
Mr. Crozier.
Here.
And we do have the one out of order resolution. So you want to go to commercial break or continue on? We'll continue with our agenda here on this file. And again, when they show up, please let us know and then we'll come right back into this. But we do have one public hearing this evening, and just a reminder that we've extended the public comment for the public hearings portion to 4 minutes. And I respectively ask that each person comment only on the subject relevant to the public hearing itself. Thank you. And I have one individual signed up tonight, and that's Ms. Julia Hoffman, please.
City Council. My name is Julia Hope. I'm a teacher at Schenectady High School and also the advisor for the Schenectady High School Christian Alliance, our Christian Club. And all across the United States this Wednesday, they have a program called See You at the Poll. And what it is that we invite the public and our city leaders, to meet us at Schenectady High School at the flagpole from 8 to 8:15, just to come and pray. And it doesn't make any difference what your belief system is. We just want people to come out and just pray for the safety of everyone within the school district, from the janitorial staff to our superintendent, everyone. And so if you're available for 15 minutes from 8 o'clock to 8:15 this Wednesday, that's for the 26th, see you at the polls. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hoffman. Again, a good seeing you as well. Thank you for what you do in our community. And I do have, there's somebody else signed up for the public hearing, so we'll declare that closed. And if I could just, we'll go through it here real quick. Ask you to approve the minutes for September 10th, 2018, was moved by Mr. Palmetti, second by Mr. Karen's DW. And if I can ask the clerk to read the communications and petitions.
Communication presented to the City Council for Monday, September 24, 2018. Under the category of official from the mayor, a list of appointments dated September 24, 2018. Under general, there are none, and under petitions, there are none.
Thank you. We'll remove it to agree based on Ms. Peraza correctly pointed out. I need a motion to accept the minutes for September 10th. Mr. Karen ZW and Mr. Paul Maddie seconds, all in favor, say aye. Thank you very much. All right, and now let's go back to the presentation for COVID.
Mr. President?
Yes.
Thank you. This is a resolution recognizing the 10th anniversary of Cocoa House, Inc. Whereas Cocoa House, Inc. is a 501c3 nonprofit organization offering free after-school tutoring and academic enrichment programs in Schenectady, New York. And whereas the acronym COCO, C-O-C-O-A, stands for Children of Our Community Open to Achievement. And whereas the Cocoa House was founded by Rachel Graham and now overseen by Executive Director William Rivas. And whereas the Board of Directors is comprised of students and alumni of Union College, and whereas Cocoa House's mission is to help our city's at-risk youth achieve academic success and develop sustainable life skills in a safe after-school environment, and whereas Cocoa House relies on grant money, private donations, and volunteers to help students complete their homework, to provide school supplies and tutoring on a variety of school subjects, and to offer students an after-school meal. And whereas the students of Cocoa House often live in the Hamilton Hill neighborhood, and whereas Cocoa House offers these at-risk youth a safe place, supportive learning environment, and friendly atmosphere to visit each day after school. And whereas Cocoa House serves as an important role in the city of Schenectady, our neighborhood communities, and the lives of young students who rely on its safe space and free services. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Mayor Gary R. McCarthy and the City Council do hereby recognize and celebrate the 10th anniversary of Cocoa House, Inc. and its valuable contributions to the City of Schenectady and its youth. I'd like to move this.
Moved by Ms. Brassett, second by Ms. Porterfield. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Congratulations.
I'm sorry, I spent her 10th anniversary in Texas, actually 22 years, but that's my fault, not hers. I'm thankful for the opportunity. Myself and my sister, we were one of the first students in the Cocoa House when it opened 22 years ago. I actually studied for my final exams there back in 1998, so to have the opportunity to come back and become the executive director and continue the mission of the Cocoa House for the kids in our community, it's a great opportunity. Schenectady means a lot to me. The kids mean a lot to me. It's an important opportunity. So I thank you guys very much. Please come out and visit the kids. We have a great bunch of youth in the community who are there. We hope to see you soon. Thank you.
Thank you. And so we'll continue to move on here with the privilege of the floor related to the legislative agenda. I have two folks signed up. First speaker is Mary McClain.
Good evening. Item number 6, a resolution adopting the City of Schenectady Sexual Harassment Prevention Policy. This resolution does not go far enough. What about the safety factor? No woman should be expected to work alone in this building late at night on the night shift. That is asking for trouble. Anything can happen. A person falls, the elevator jams, a sudden medical incident occurs, and the employee is left without any backup help. The safety issue applies to anyone, man or woman, who works the late night shift. These resolutions sound great on paper, but in actuality, they are meaningless. If a woman is left alone in this facility to work the night shift, it should not happen, but it has. Neither the council nor the mayor have the workers' best interest on their radar. The workers are also their constituents. People must work for a living. It doesn't mean they should jeopardize their lives for it. Concentrate on the total picture. Make it safe for employees to work at night in this large building. Thank you.
Thank you. And I have P. Morris.
Sam reported, reminded my mother's pooch's name, Samuel Bangs, and she certainly did. I did not speak against that legislation. I asked a lot of questions about it, and particularly about the reporting mechanism that I don't think the reporting mechanism, and this is just a guess, will be done in public. I think it will probably be done in executive session. And we never have privy to the executive session, nor when it comes before, whatever is discussed there comes before the public, we don't get to hear what you hear about it. And as far as I'm concerned, there are still issues about this that bother me, particularly when it's being created. And training for police officers and firefighters to improve wellness and morale of public safety officers. Morale? What kind of morale problems do they have that they have to have this type of legislation? And then it says the foundation the services prior to the approval of the Schenectady Police Chief or Schenectady Fire Chief. Where is Commissioner Items, what or where is his role regarding this. I still think it needs to be discussed longer. I think a lot more forethought needs to be go into this, and I don't think there's anything about this that is that necessarily something that can't be put off for a couple of months. So that's my position on that, and I stand. But I'm not opposed necessarily to it, and I think there were things like gifts from people, obviously, I think, that you had something in the mind before you even wrote this up. Maybe even what you have in mind caused this, because this whole thing does not sound like good law to me. Thank you.
Thank you. And if no one else has signed up to speak, so I declare the public comment on legislative agenda closed, and I can ask for approval of the legislative consent agenda. Mr. Paul Menney, second by Mr. Milton Barron. All fair say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. And I will now call on the privilege of the floor regarding the general city business, and we have three individuals signed up, and Ms. Joy Hall, come on up.
I'm Joy Hall, Schenectady. We got three problems. Number one thing, we got to put some bumpers or something down Millard Street, up and down, because they speed like crazy. Gotta stop. Too many accidents have happened down there. And another, and they do it on State Street too. And if people stop at the red light, wait for the arrow to make a left hand turn, people are coming in. And coming around a person on the right hand side and on the left hand side, somebody's going to get hurt. They got to do something about that too. And it's got to stop. Too many things have happened already in town. I've seen a lot of stuff happen, and I know. And another thing we got to do is work on the streets and build lighting potholes. Potholes are bad. And a lot of streets need their lines redone. I've seen it all the way. And Eric Boulevard is another place where they see it. Something that we done got down there too. We can't have these people speeding. Somebody's gonna get hurt. I hate to have to say this, but it's the truth. I've seen too much of this going on. It's got to stop now.
Very good. Thank you, Ms. Hall. Mary McClain, please.
I take umbrage to the comments that the realtor slash councilwoman made about the better neighborhoods in Schenectady. I noticed she mentioned her own neighborhood, but not Goose Hill. If her neighborhood is so great, why didn't she move from Glenville sooner? She purchased a house in Schenectady in 2011. 5 years later, council saw fit to appoint her to a council seat. In her open stage media vignette, she says it was time to accept a council seat because she has held seats on other boards. That is fudging the truth. Residency made the appointment lawful. No residency, no eligibility, not time. Her comments to the Gazette reporter were biased and offensive to every taxpayer who pays her salary. I have walked the streets of this city at least 7 times carrying petitions of one kind or another. I have been to places where people told me no one had ever been to their door to ask for a signature. One man asked, how did you find me? I went to a house in the Bellevue section that
when I commented how beautiful the property was, the homeowner invited me to look around. There is something for everybody in Schenectady. Residency should be a must for all city employees. Earlier this summer, we saw members of the police and fire departments receive promotions. Their resumes were read. Residency was not included. 80 new teachers were hired for the 2018-19 school year. How many live in Schenectady? 17 school personnel retired this summer and walked away with more than $500,000 in cash plus other benefits. Taxpayers footed the bill. Men, how many live in Schenectady? Residency brings in tax dollars. At the committee meeting of September 17th, the mayor said maintenance matches up with revenue. That means no money and the city doesn't get clean. But public employees can pad their lifetime benefits. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. McClain. And our last speaker is Judy Boris, please. Thank you.
Just because somebody in the police department or the fire department has a morale problem doesn't mean you can bring in the king's kids from Uncle Milton, Uncle Willie, or any of your uncle families to get very verbal. And we have there's a whole cattle call over there to the mission. They're from all over the place, all over the country. But there's stockade over there, talk about backyard birds. It's overcrowded there. I even wonder if the fire department might have some concentration problems regarding that. And that statue, if you've ever been to the Statue of Liberty, it's humongous. But it was given to us as a denouement of a replica of the horse in the Battle of Troy. And when you open the Pandora's box, what comes out? Not the friend that you thought, but the enemy. And that could happen here and has happened here. That Colossus poem from Colossus was not on the statue when it was placed there. And when I came here and saw that statue in the park, first I laughed. It looked so bizarre, but I don't miss it one bit. I think it's just funny that you aren't taking seriously what that image is, and the pastor ought to know that that statue and her, it's the bell, book, and candle ceremony of excommunication, and if you don't know about it, Google it. And then to this cute little stuff on the street here, did anybody ask permission to do that? And what are the guys going to do about that with a snowplow? Did anybody check with the fire department? There are six street lights at every short block along here. I've never in 20 years even heard of an accident at this street lamp with a corner of a one-way street. And then, too, the stuff about another statue or commemorative thing in Niskayuna on that hill in Niskayuna. And then you're going to do Columbus Day, polarized. It's the same event, and one gets celebrated, and the other is still being castrated. Well, almost 500, we're going into 75 years after. Which Holocaust is the good Holocaust, and which Holocaust is the bad Holocaust?
Can you just summarize this for us, please? Thank you, man. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And no one else has signed up to speak. So I declare the closure of one close. I'm calling my fellow colleagues from the council for any miscellaneous items that are remembered. we'd like to ask Mr. Mudavaran to get on the Parks and Rec agenda for next time around, making sure our parks are signed off properly and uniformly. I understand there's some parks that the no smoking signs aren't erected, and also the ordinance that we passed 2 or 3 years ago about parks closed at dusk. I know Fairview Park is still signed off at 9 o'clock. So 9 o'clock in the dead of winter is probably about 5 hours after it's dark. So I'd like to discuss that and make sure we get signal control so we have a uniform signage in our city parks for sure. The other thing I want to address is some of the panhandling that's going on is kind of getting out of control. A person that called me and said that they were at the ATM machine at Westinghouse Place at the Key Bank, and they were basically accosted, someone asking them for money, and that's kind of dangerous when it happens at ATM machines. And the other thing is, the people that are panhandling at the 890 ramp, Broadway ramp, it's dangerous down there. There's no sidewalk. They shouldn't be there. We're going to have to start, I think, enforcing some of this just a little better. They're there on a regular basis. You can't be, and that's a long line, and they just walk up and down with the signs. And it's a dangerous situation. It's not that they leave the signs there when they leave, and the signs stay there just to be picked up again. I'm all for people, you know, if they're asking for help, we have plenty of places for people to get help, but to stand there in the roadway, in a busy roadway, somebody that's hurt, who's going to be liable with this? But I get complaints about this. I'm sure probably other council people do, too. But it just doesn't give a good image for the city, and especially at places like that 890 ramp is it's a dangerous place for people to be panhandling, and ATM machines is just something new to me. First I heard of this, but it happened Sunday when a person that I know called and said they were asked for money for diapers at the ATM machine. So I think it's something moving forward we have to address to make this a better place to live. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else? Ms. Bradley?
Yes, thank you. I just want to recognize that September 22nd, Schenectady County did their honor of that ceremony, and this month they honored Sergeant Joseph P. Blesser in memoriam, and just always a wonderful tribute and a time to reflect, thank our veterans for their service, thank their family for the sacrifice, and just a good time to come together and remember. In addition, as both a council person and a Rotarian, I would like to let everyone know that on Saturday, September 29th, from 9 to 12 p.m., the Schenectady Rotary is doing a spread event in Schenectady, and this is going to help support the SCCC food pantry. It's going to be held at Saratoga National Bank, 251 State Street in Schenectady. It will be held in the back parking lot, which is actually located on Liberty Street. You can bring up to 2 boxes of your documents. There's no charge. They will be safely destroyed. But they do ask that you donate 2 personal care items, and they're looking for laundry detergent, toilet bowl cleaner, dryer sheets, dish soap, Windex, deodorant, full-size deodorant, shampoo, conditioner, body wash, household cleaner, bathroom cleaner, feminine hygiene products, which is really an important thing that people forget about, toilet paper, paper towels, etc. So that is Saturday, September 29th from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Also, the Thriving Neighborhoods Challenge was announced last week to a packed crowd, standing room only, which shows you the level of engagement that our citizens have in this initiative. To find out more about the community meetings being held in individual neighborhoods, you can go to the Schenectady Foundation website. But they're looking for projects. They have a total of $250,000 that they'll be giving in individual grants to neighborhoods for ideas on how to improve the neighborhoods. So, and I know that some of our CDBG money went toward that effort in addition to some private funding and funding through the Schenectady Foundation. And lastly, I just want to say that I'm thrilled this evening that we are moving forward with regard to our towing services. This has been lagging for 5.5 years, and hence the city has not been realizing the revenue from this. And if you listen regularly, you'll know that I've been asking for regular updates and trying to encourage that we move forward with this, because every bit of revenue for our taxpayers is important. And so I hope that now that the council has passed the rates, that the mayor will move forward with his professional services contract as soon as possible, and we can start reaping the benefits of this legislation. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just a couple of announcements. First of all, the Schenectady East Rotary Club and the Ancient Order of Hibernians is sponsoring a fundraising pancake breakfast this Sunday at the Ancient Order of Hibernians on State Street. It's a great way to support the Hibernians, and I'd love to have everybody come out. The Woodlawn Park Committee meeting is this Wednesday at 6 o'clock at the Ancient Order of Hibernians. They're going to be picking days for their cleanups, their annual wake-up day. Usually they do it early November or late October. And this week we also have the 12309 neighborhood meeting on Tuesday. So I think I've got everything. Thanks for talking about credit with the Rotary. I was going to do that. That's it. Thanks.
Thank you. Anybody else?
Thank you. First of all, I'd like to thank the Union College students that came out during their pre-orientation day. I know they were all over the city, but in particular, they were in Hamilton Hill doing some cleanup and getting ready for a family fun day that one of the churches was having. So just want to thank those students. They get really engaged. And also the president of the college, David Harris, was there with them and spent the entire time. So I appreciate what he brings to this community. I'd like to congratulate him also on his inauguration and that he has already gotten involved in the community. And I'd like to offer my condolences to the family of Ralph Boyd. Our council president spoke of him in his military service, but Mr. Boyd was more than that. He was an elder in our community, a very, very much involved in the community. He was very involved in the founding of the Baptist Retirement Center. And beyond that, he continued to do things in the community up until, I'm going to say, when he was like 95, still out there doing things and visiting offices. He was a member of the Community Fathers. So he will be greatly missed. He has a wonderful legacy in this community, and he was a wonderful role model for many people in the community throughout our city. So just condolences to his family and many, many friends, and we'll certainly miss him. Thank you.
Well said, both, thank you. Mr. Mulderman.
Thank you. Just a quick reminder to the homeowners, the permit fee waiver for all exterior work is coming to an end September 30th. So I would like to just remind the homeowner who are thinking about doing exterior work to please pull that permit and complete your exterior work. You have 6 months to complete the necessary work and get it inspected and passed. And please take advantage of this incentive that we're giving to homeowner. It's also the exterior work is $56, and for roof it is $100. And just a reminder for the people who are doing paving work, if it's a driveway, a sidewalk, or backyard, please, you're required to pull a permit, and you're required to have that work done as per the permit specification. So please do not go beyond the specification as approved by zoning and code enforcement, because you can find yourself in some trouble by even having to dig it up and bring it back to code. So once again, please make sure you're pulling your permit for all paving work that has been done in your yard. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Last but not least, Mr. Paul Miller.
Also this Thursday is the Goose Hill Neighborhood Association at 7 p.m. at the Simons Park Community Center. On October 11th, the Bellevue Preservation Association, so get that on your calendar early, will be having their second candidate tonight. The Democratic candidates for office will be presenting their spouse and their platforms. That's at 7 p.m. at St. Paul's Episcopal Church. And then as we enter into budget season, we have a series of new town hall meetings. They'll be at 7 p.m. on October 3rd at the St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Bellevue. October 4th is a Thursday. We'll be at Simons Park Community Room at 7 p.m. And October 5th, the Friday, will be at the Bridge Church at 5:30. That's a little earlier since it's a Friday evening. We will give a brief overview of the budget. We ask that people come with suggestions. That's really what this is about, giving people an extra opportunity to provide their input into the budget. We really look for suggestions as to things that we could do, and any ideas are more than welcome. We also will be doing the budget process a little bit different, and instead of a line item approach to the budget, more of a budget performance overview. The distinction being comparing column A with column B and just looking at how money is spent versus actual performance. What are the outcomes? What are the goals? What are the objectives? And then holding people accountable, holding departments accountable. That's a big difference in my mind, how we approach the budget. I think an important distinction. And with that in mind, we ask people to consider that when they come to the town hall meetings. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just in follow-up to Councilwoman Barrasso on the Thriving Neighborhood Challenge being done by John Schenectady Foundation, there are three specific meetings that are still going to be held looking for neighborhood input and to get the idea and concepts out there for individuals within the neighborhood, for groups to be able to put proposals forward. At the Early Childhood Center at 1840 there in Rankin Avenue, Monday, September 24th, that'll be at 6 p.m. Wednesday, September 26th, Steinmetz Homes Community Room on Clement Street. And Wednesday, October 3rd, at the Schenectady County Public Library, Kitty Corner from City Hall, that'll be at 6:30 p.m. And tomorrow is National Voter Registration Day, so that anybody who is turning 18 before Election Day may have moved since they last voted, or for some other reason is not registered to vote, would encourage you to either go to the Board of Elections, downloadable forms on the both state and the county board elections website. And the League of Women Voters in Schenectady County will be hosting voter registration drives at four locations within the city tomorrow. At Union College, they're going to have one from noon till 6 p.m. At SUNY Schenectady Community College, it's noon to 6 p.m. also. At the YWCA at 44 Washington Avenue, they'll have tables out from 8:30 in the morning till 10:30. And then again from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. And also at the YMCA at 433 State Street, they'll be available to do registration from 10 a.m. till noon, and then from 4:30 till 7:30 p.m. Again, encourage everyone to come out, and if you're not registered, take the time to register to vote, because every vote does count. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir. And again, to follow with Councilman John Clement, and thank you for setting up these town hall meetings and the rest of the council. I think it's very important that we're showing our transparency and getting out to meet the public and hear their needs and concerns, especially after we hear the mayor's proposed budget, which he has to present to us on or before October 1st. I don't believe there's a date or time set for that yet. But again, we have three different meeting sets and scheduled in three different neighborhoods, and we certainly encourage folks to come out. And again, just talk to the council, work with us. We all know what our problems are, what we need to work on, but how do we address it? What are you looking for? How can we work with you, our residents and citizens of the city of Schenectady? And again, to Ralph Boyd Sr. And his family. I believe he's a platoon winner as well. We worked many years with him when I was with the Boys and Girls Club through many of our schools, including Mount Pleasant Middle Schools and Martin Luther King School. And he was just a figure to those youth there
very proud as a council member to really be a sponsor and a donor through the CBG funding for this wonderful initiative, which is really getting some great press coverage and some great energy from our entire city. I think Bob Crow said it in his opening comments on Craig Street there just last week. He said, "Do you feel the energy in the city of Schenectady? Do you feel it changing?" And we certainly do. And again, we're looking to hear from our neighborhoods and from our residents to come and work with us and work with the foundation. The mayor has listed the other events that they were speaking at. They're also going to be at the Woodland Neighbor Association meeting this Wednesday at 7 p.m. at the Ancient Order Hibernian Hall at 1748 State Street. So Mr. Carroll will be there for that as well. One final thing. The Rotterdam Senior Center, as we know, is closed, but I do want to extend our open invitation to anybody who's watching or listening this evening to our seniors in the town of Rotterdam to join us and partake in the wonderful events and opportunities that we have at the Spencer Senior Center right on the Ancient Order of Hibernians, again, in partnership with Kingsway Community. This week, we've got, on Tuesday, we've got the Blood Pressure Clinic from Kingsway, bingo and board games. Thursday was a very popular Cheer Moves, which is being joined by MVP and their partnership, and they're doing the monthly birthday bash. So if anybody has any birthdays coming, lunch is real quick because they're selling out, folks. Let me tell you what, we've been turning away people at 11:30 because they're sold out. So get there early. Lunch is Tuesday, goulash, Thursday's potluck, and of course, the membership is free. So please, I'll be there Tuesday if anybody wants to join me serving the table. So it's just a great, wonderful opportunity for everybody to be there. Anything else to come before the council this evening? And again, our prayers and condolences to Ralph Boyd and family. So I need a motion to adjourn, please. Mr. Paul Manning, Inspector Member, Mr. Regional Affairs, say aye.
Aye.
Thank you, and have a good evening.